It is with great pleasure that I present to you Dr. Peter Emanuel, Ripon College Class of 1981 for the Distinguished Alumni Citation. I'm Colleen Byron, Professor and Chair of the Ripon College Chemistry Department. Peter's originally from Marshfield and graduated with a chemistry major at Ripon College. But I learned earlier today that he also began barefoot water skiing while at Ripon College and continued that through his medical school years, which followed immediately after Ripon College. Went to the University of Wisconsin-Madison, was on the ski show team throughout medical school, and as a medical, as a pre-health advisor, I'm going to have to work on that one with some of my current students. But after the University of Wisconsin, his residency and fellowships took him to the University of Alabama, Birmingham. And what was remarkable there was his second fellowship that was more focused on research in the field of hematology and oncology. It's a little bit of an unusual career path to go from an MD to more of a research type of career. And Peter told me earlier today that that was a pretty lucky turn of events for him. And he promised his wife he would only be in Alabama for 3 years, and they were there till 2007. And so it was a few more than that, but his promotions through the academic ranks at UAB coincided with a number of funded research grant proposals focused on treatments for what was called at the time juvenile chronic myelogenous leukemia, which is now known as juvenile myelocystic leukemia. And the treatments that he came up with ranged from the use of derivatives of vitamin A to stem cell transplantation. This is a very aggressive disease with a medium age of onset of being 2 years of age for this form of leukemia. And in working with this disease, Dr. Emanuel has faced many challenges with finding the right combination of treatments and in working with families having to make very difficult decisions on an uncertain medical landscape. As a chemist myself, I am particularly drawn to Dr. Emanuel's motivation to identify molecular defects responsible for the aggressiveness of this juvenile leukemia. In 2007, Dr. Emanuel was named the director of the Winthrop P. Rockefeller Cancer Institute and the Kent C. Westbrook MD Director's Endowed Chair at the University of Arkansas for Medical Sciences, and has been living in Little Rock, Arkansas for about the last 10 years. He remains an attending staff physician in addition to his directorship and is currently listed in the Best Doctors in America, America's Top Doctors for Cancer, and America's Top Doctors. He belongs to an international children's oncology group, which together conducts and publishes research and treatment outcomes in juvenile leukemia and other childhood cancers. Please join me in congratulating Dr. Peter Emanuel on his many achievements in the field of cancer medicine and on being awarded the Distinguished Alumni Citation by Ripon College.
Thank you and good evening. I also want to thank the Ripon College Alumni Association Board of Directors for this award. Thank you, Professor Byron, for introducing me. It was great earlier today to catch up with Rich Scammerhorn and Skip Whitler. It's good to see members of both biology and chemistry faculties that I saw many, many years ago. To be recognized by one's peers is perhaps the greatest honor. And I was very grateful back in 1992 to receive the Outstanding Young Alumni Award from Ripon, and now to be honored and recognized a second time is very humbling. I think, at least so far, Thomas Horvath, an 84 alum, who's a current NASA engineer, is the only other one who has received both the honors, and I assume that there will be many, many others following in their footsteps. I feel very fortunate to be involved at a time in cancer research where technology is allowing us to identify genetic mutations that cause cancer, and to be involved at a time when we are rapidly developing new treatments, such as immunotherapies and targeted therapies that are moving us away from toxic modalities such as we used in the past, chemotherapy and radiation therapy. Not to say that we're abandoning those, but some of our new modalities are quickly helping us in that fight. A typical example is President Jimmy Carter. Many of you heard a year or so ago that he was diagnosed with widely spread melanoma, our deadliest form of skin cancer. And he kind of said his swan song at the time, and all of us in cancer heard him and said, well, not so fast, President Carter. And in fact, he's gone on our new immunotherapies and was declared in complete remission just a few months ago. So there is much hope out there for cancer patients. Cancer is not one disease, but hundreds of diseases. And we will never have a single cure for cancer, but we'll have to come up with different treatments for all the different forms of cancer. But beyond all these advances in cancer research, all of us as individuals can do much if we eat healthy, do things in moderation, and most importantly, avoid tobacco. There is absolutely nothing good about tobacco, and it is responsible for 40% of all the cancer deaths in America. Just think of the energy that we could spend on the other 60% if we didn't have to worry about that 40%. It contributes to at least 9 different types of cancer. We need to get rid of it. I want to thank my wife for all of her support and being there right there with me as we push cancer research and cancer research funding. Believe me, she is more beautiful on the inside than her study looks outside. My father was a class of 45 alum and a longtime cardiologist at the Marshfield Clinic. He died earlier this year, just before his 93rd birthday, but I was able to inform him of my receiving this honor before he died, and he was very pleased. A liberal arts education provides an absolutely great start to life. The equivalent in Arkansas of Ripon is Hendricks College. And a year ago, I was honored to represent Ripon when they inaugurated the new president of Hendricks College, William Sensui, and that tradition, like colleges have representatives from all over, and I was able to walk and represent Ripon. It was wonderful. Liberal arts educations are extremely valuable, and I'm very pleased that all 3 of my children attended a liberal arts college for at least part of their education. I value everything I receive here at Ripon, and I thank you again for this honor. Thank you very much.